This video introduces the ServiceNow Express features for managing users in your organization. As you set up your ServiceNow Express instance for the first time, you'll use these features to tailor it to your organization. Going forward, you'll use these features to update your instance as the need arises. Before we explore the features for managing users, let's take a quick look at users, groups, and roles. Each person in your organization who uses the ServiceNow Express system is defined in the system as a user. You can create groups of users who perform the same functions, like resolving incidents or performing work order tasks. Users are defined with roles that correspond to their jobs, like system administrator or service desk staff. These roles let the users access the functions and data they need for their jobs. With that in mind, let's take a look at managing users. To see the users defined in the system, we navigate to Users in the User Administration menu. We can sort the list by any field, filter the list by one or more fields, and perform lots more functions. We can also add new users and edit existing users. You can import a list of users into your instance using an Excel spreadsheet. This is an easy way to define many users, especially when you're setting up your instance for the first time. You can also update existing users this way. To import a list of users, click the context menu icon next to any column name and choose Import. Follow the instructions to create a spreadsheet and import the data into your instance. Next, let's take a look at groups. A group is a set of users who perform the same function, like resolving incidents or performing work order tasks. A user can be in more than one group. By organizing your users in groups, you can find group members easily in the system by searching or filtering, or send notifications to them easily. To see the groups defined in your instance, we navigate to Groups in the User Administration menu. As we saw for the user list, we can sort and filter the group list and perform many other functions. Groups can be organized in a hierarchy, with parent groups containing one or more child groups. Here, the parent group called Database contains three child groups, Database Atlanta, Database San Diego, and NYDB. To add a new group, click New and enter the properties of the new group. If you want the new group to be a child within a parent group, specify the parent group name. To assign members to a group, first we click the name of the group in the Groups list to display details about the group. The current members are listed in the Group Members related list. Then we click Edit to display the Edit Members page, where we can add or remove members. We can filter or search both lists to find specific users. Next, we'll take a look at roles. Users are defined in the system with one or more roles that correspond to their jobs, like system administrator or service desk staff. Each role has access to specific functions and data. By assigning roles to groups or users, you give them access to the functions and data they need for their jobs. To see the roles defined in our instance, we navigate to Roles in the User Administration menu. The base system comes with several common roles. When you're setting up your instance for the first time, see if these roles are sufficient for your organization. To define a new role, we click New and enter a name and description for the new role. Each role gives users access to the specific applications and modules they need for their job. To see this information, click the name of a role in the list. The Applications with Role tab shows the applications available to this role, and the Modules with Role tab shows the modules. To change the applications or modules available to a role, we click Basic Setup on the System Administrator homepage, and then click Applications. To see which roles an application is assigned to, we click that application in the list. The Application Menu page shows which role the application is assigned to. To add or remove a role, we click the Edit icon. You can control roles' access to individual modules in the same way. Each user and group is assigned one or more roles. To see the roles assigned to a particular user, we navigate to the users list and open the user record. The user's roles are displayed on the Roles tab at the bottom. To change the roles assigned to a user, we click Edit. The Edit Members page lets us add or remove roles for the user. You can assign roles to a group in the same way from the Groups list. If you need to assign the same role to several users or groups, there's a quick way to do that. Navigate to the Roles module, click the role you want to assign, and click Edit on the Users tab. The Edit Members page lets you add or remove multiple users. Now let's take a look at the options for configuring our instance to provide single sign-on for users, Okta, SAML, and LDAP integration. The base system comes with an Okta integration that provides single sign-on through the Okta OpenID authentication service. To activate Okta, we click User Administration on the System Administrator homepage, click Okta Plugin, and follow the instructions to set up Okta. As an alternative to Okta, you can provide single sign-on through a different identity provider using SAML protocol. The SAML integration lets the system exchange authentication data with an external identity provider. To configure SAML single sign-on, navigate to Single Sign-On in the User Administration menu. The Single Sign-On page lets you specify identity providers, certificates, and other properties. For example, the automatic provisioning of users from the identity provider. You can also integrate an external LDAP server with your instance to streamline the user login process and import data from your corporate directory service. To do this, navigate to LDAP in the User Administration menu. You can add a new server or modify an existing one. The Configure Server tab lets you specify LDAP server properties. The OU Definitions tab lets you import organizational data like users and groups into your instance. This is a quick way to build your lists of users and groups when you're setting up the system. Here you can specify the target table and the items to import. You can also schedule periodic imports and create a transform map to match fields between the LDAP server and your instance. Finally, let's take a look at a few other entities you can define. Departments, locations, and companies. Like groups, these are all ways of categorizing users so that you can find them easily in the system by searching or filtering and send notifications to them easily. Departments are useful for categorizing users by their internal organization, like finance, sales, or human resources. To see the departments defined in your instance, click Departments in the User Administration menu in the Application Navigator. To see the users in any department, just click the department name. To define a new department, we click New on the Departments page. To assign a user to a department, we navigate to Users in the User Administration menu, click the name of the user in the list, and choose a department. Locations are useful for categorizing users by geographical location. To see the locations defined in our instance, we navigate to Locations in the User Administration menu. To see the details of any location, we just click the location name. Locations can be organized in a hierarchy, with parent locations containing one or more child locations, as we saw earlier with groups. For example, you could define multiple buildings within one city and multiple floors in one building. Companies are useful for categorizing users in companies you do business with, like customers and vendors. To see the companies defined in our instance, we navigate to Companies. To see the details of any company, we just click the company name. We assign a user to a location or company on the user form, like we did for department. To do this, you may need to add the location or company field to the user form, as we've done here. For more information on adding fields to a form, please see Configure a Form in the product documentation. For more information, please consult our product documentation, videos, or blogs, or ask a question in the ServiceNow Express forums.